Welcome back, everybody. We are in the first Dark World dungeon. Looking for the boss and the treasure. This is the collapsing bridge of death. So, yeah. There's the compass. Which door? Which door? We're going to the right. The right is always right. Oh wait, this is just a money room. For whatever reason, these rupees have a smaller hitbox, and like rupees dropped by enemies. Like if I walk across the top, I don't pick it up. You have to hit it like dead center. There's a key, so it wasn't just the money room. Good for me. And there's some arrows, I guess. Woo. Oh, I guess that I realized that I just realized that I picked up the mushroom without getting what it's used for. So I guess I'll do that after I get out of here also. Oh, both staircases took you to the same place. Silly Ike. Alright, so I believe we're on our way to get the treasure now. Because I'm sure you guys saw the chest. These guys shoot fireballs, they're annoying. That's where I want to go, I think. I always get lost in rooms like this. There's a chest. Oh boy, bombs. I guess that'd be useful if I didn't have any, because I have to bomb through a wall anyway. Oh. Ah. Oh, good thing I grabbed that. This is only a two-floor dungeon. And here it is. The magic hammer. It lets you hammer stakes. And that's about it. You hammer stakes. It's useful for the boss here, but that's about it. Outside of that, it's only useful for getting to certain areas. I mean, you can use it as a weapon. These little things with helmets on, helmosaurs, that like were on that bridge, you can kill them like immediately with the magic hammer. The turtle things, the hammer will flip them over so you can hit them that way. Otherwise, they can't be damaged. I didn't even notice this door here. Alright. So now, I think I'm actually on my way to the boss now. I look like I'm at about 4 to 5 minutes in. This is the annoying part. You can't just push that button. You have to take the time to push the statue there. More of these guys. I'm so used to playing like the Game Boy games, like Link's Awakening, oops. Or the Oracle games, where when you swing the sword, the path of the sword is the hitbox. But with like this, I can swing the sword and not hit enemies that are being hit by the animation of the sword. Oh, I guess I can hit those guys with my sword. Oops. Actually, I do need the bow for this room. Once again, you can see the lining on the floor doesn't go along that wall. Shooting that thing in the eye opens it up. Another long animation. And here we go. Stop hammer time. If I don't get myself killed right off the bat. Yeah, normally I have the magic boomerang in this room. I guess it'll work fine with the regular boomerang. I do not have a key. So I missed something. Alright, moving back out. Yeah. What did I miss? That area. Oh, wait, that's where I just was. What key did I miss? Is it the one up above me? There it is. How do I get to that? Oh wow, I feel stupid. I should have gone that way earlier. There we go. And now I just have to walk all the way back. With that sound ringing in my ears, I'm aware I'm at low health. Have to re-kill these. Oh, so I guess these green things mimic me left and right, but not up and down. It's the opposite up and down. The red things mimic me completely. Sharpshooter of the year. Enemies respawn, pots don't. And the turtles do. All right, I think I'm going through time quite a bit here. That was my last fairy. I don't know why I'm having so much trouble with simple enemies. I forgot I could do that. Alright, guys. In this episode, we are still in the first dungeon. And, we got the magic mallet. Next episode, we will take on the boss. See you next time.